Welcome to West Wing Week.
Welcome to the West Wing Week, your guide to everything that's happening at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. And in space. This week, the President welcomed to the White House the President of South Korea, the Prime Minister of Pakistan, hosted CEOs who are tackling climate change, traveled to West Virginia for a community discussion on drug abuse, and spent an evening stargazing with space lovers for the White House Astronomy Night.
The kids are so excited about meeting some astronauts.
That's October 16th to October 22nd, or...
I love Astronomy Night.
I love Astronomy Night!
On Friday, the President met with President Park of South Korea in the Oval Office, and then held a news conference in the East Room. On Monday, the First Lady launched the Better Make Room campaign, a part of her Reach Higher initiative to encourage young people to pursue a higher education.
Determined to be a first-generation college graduate.
Meanwhile, in the West Wing, the President hosted a roundtable with CEOs and announced that 81 of the largest companies in the world have pledged to take steps to reduce carbon pollution.
Well, I just had the opportunity to meet with CEOs from across the country who are acting on climate change.
The conversation continued that afternoon as business leaders discussed the commitments that they had made to the effort.
And all of the effects we're starting to see, we're seeing those in our supply chain. We have to make those changes more sustainable.
And later, the Vice President joined the discussion.
You have more impact on the nature of this debate going forward over the next 5 to 10 years than any other part of the economy. You. And I can't thank you enough for stepping up.
Later, the President made a phone call that was out of this world.
We've been following your Instagram feed down here. It is spectacular.
And that evening, in the spirit of space exploration, the White House welcomed students and scientists to the South Lawn for the White House Astronomy Night.
We are setting you loose. We've got some incredible exhibits all over the place. Not just this telescope, but we've got a mini planetarium and virtual reality and real reality and... So there's all kinds of good stuff. I hope you guys have a wonderful time tonight. I hope that all of you are inspired the way I am by science and by space.
On Tuesday, the President met with the 2014 Enrico Fermi Award recipients to celebrate their achievements in physics and energy research. On Wednesday, the President joined the Vice President, who made an important announcement in the Rose Garden.
But while I will not be a candidate, I will not be silent. I intend to speak out clearly and forcefully to influence as much as I can where we stand as a party and where we need to go as a nation.
Later, the President traveled to Charleston, West Virginia, to meet with members of the community and hear firsthand how prescription drug and heroin abuse are ravaging local communities, not just in West Virginia, but all across the country.
The bottom line is we need resources, and we need to find a way to put those resources into effect. So that we have the facility, because there's so many people that want help, like our daughter, but it took forever to find a place for her. Mr. President, I want to say that it is, and I'm going to take this opportunity, it is wonderful to have an intelligent, caring, thoughtful person in your position.
Meanwhile, the First Lady traveled to Akron, Ohio, alongside favorite son LeBron James. They joined a fired-up crowd to talk about her recently launched Better Make Room campaign.
We want to make room for you and your stories. So instead of everybody always talking about folks like me and LeBron and the next reality TV show, we want them to talk about kids like you.
On Thursday, the President hosted Prime Minister Sharif of Pakistan at the White House.
Thank you.
Later, the President answered questions about criminal justice reform in a conversation that was hosted here at the White House by the Marshall Project.
First thing they did when they came, brought in new recruits, they just put them in the neighborhoods where they're going to be serving. They had to walk basically for 24 hours, right? And if they needed to go to the restroom, they needed to get to know some people. And so they started meeting local businesses. And the chief talks about sometimes we know who the drug dealers are. Instead of arresting them where they're just going to be released, we're just going to have an officer stand right next to them. and talking to them and asking them, why are you doing this? Smart community policing. Really can have an impact, really can make a difference.
That evening, the President vetoed a bill passed by Republicans in Congress that would rely on an accounting gimmick to fund our armed forces.
I'm going to be sending it back to Congress, and my message to them is very simple. Let's do this right.
So stay engaged with us online, and remember, you can find out more information about any of these topics and see complete videos of these events at whitehouse.gov. Thanks so much for checking out this edition of your West Wing Week.
Thank you.
Appreciate you guys. You've been running around a lot, especially the cameramen with the big things that they're like. You guys are staying in shape, though.